Right? desk that third time that I called the girl that ended up not recruiting me and sending me to someone else, I thought, I don't know what, but more, right? And so for me, I didn't know anything about Mary Baker Lane, which was really cool because she ended up being my teacher for the whole week that I went to Dallas for my leader. Mm-hmm. However, in our starter kit, I'll just be dancing for a moment, ta-da, we get this beautiful autobiography. And I don't know about y'all, but I love autobiographies. I love to hear from the person their perception of themselves and how their life has gone. And so, I mean, I read this like in 48 hours, even working my job. And I fell in love with Mary Kay and her heart for women, but also her heart for the Lord. And the fact that she wanted to create a situation. Y'all, in 1963, if you're young, let me just give you a history lesson. You're younger than many of us. You're so young in the room. In 1963, our schools were not all desegregated. Does that just not even blow your mind? Like, I cannot believe that was not my lifetime yet, but I was born just a few years later, and they still weren't all. Right? And so, for Mary Kay, as a single woman who raised three children as a single mom, to have the amazing courage and imagination, number one, to listen to the Lord, and number two, to go, I think we can do that. Y'all, she was already, she had a whole career in direct sales, like what Mary Kay is, for three different companies, and she ended up training the men who would go on to become the vice presidents of the company. And when she would question, why I'm the one training them, why don't you promote me? Their answer was, Mary Kay, they have families to provide. Hello? Anybody in this room a single mom? Ever have been? Right? Like, would that not be a slap in the face? Absolutely. And so, of course, she was mad, as any great woman would be. And so it would come to just write down everything she was mad about and realize that she could make a difference instead of just getting angry. And I was listening to a book. Does anybody like to listen to audio books? Mm-hmm. So Stephen Furtick, anybody heard of him? Sun, Stand Still, Crash the Chatterbox, he's a pastor in South Carolina. He just wrote a book called Unqualified. So that's what I was listening to. And one of the things that was so great in it said, you cannot change the world if you're not willing to tell your story.
Wow.
I like that.
It's not pretty. There's lots of chapters. We wish we could have had a rewrite, you know, just put those together and just skip on to the next good part. And yet, God designed and allowed it. You know, if He's allowed it to trickle through His fingers, because if it's touched your life, it has trickled through His fingers. The enemy does not have full permission over. So God is allowed it. He's going to bring something amazing from it, and not just for you, but for other people too. And so the fact that she was willing to even think that thought of, I'm a woman. How many women were at the head of companies in 1963? Like less than zero. Yeah. Certainly they weren't starting up their own. Purchasing the rights from a family to create, get the patents created. No, seriously, this was like insane. And it was so insane. What I love is, oh, our children are our heritage. So it's not good to say no, practice. If you're not good at having breakdowns with your kids, work on it. Don't put them in every activity. Give them time to be. They don't know they have an imagination if they never had to sit in the dirt and try to figure something out. You can play with it. Right? That is how we grow in our imagination. So don't fall into the traps, you know, that the world offers, because we live in such an abundant time, and especially with technology. And we can be deceived into thinking technology can babysit our children, but it will never parent our children. Right? There's a big difference. So what was I saying before I said that was kind of the same way? Well, right, I don't know. It's not, yes, I really don't know.
You're talking about
Because you know what it was? It wasn't the things. It was the win. How many of you can remember the last time you won? Right?
Maybe when you walk across the stage at high school graduation or college graduation or your kids graduating or, you know, your husband getting a promotion. But what if you can win every day? Would that not be more fun?
I want to win so often, I can't remember. How many wins did I have today?
I'm going to start writing that.
Right? That's the way. I think that's what God has in mind for us more than sometimes the way we think. So one of the really cool perks is sitting in the parking lot. It's large and big.
Yeah.
And it is free. And they pay for your tax and your stickers. And they pay for your oil change. I mean, is there anybody else that's just like, yes, that is how my Prince Charming would treat me?
Yeah.
My dad put gas in my mama's car and washed it for her every Saturday.
Yeah.
Right. That is a high standard. I'm not saying my husband doesn't do that, but he does tell me that he loves how much money I have.